My favorite thing about being a woodworker is being able to design the space around me. My environment has a direct impact on my creativity, so the more I create, the more I feel creative. I'm in need of a portable Bluetooth speaker, but there's nothing available that works for my space, so I'm gonna modify one that fits my style. I'm not exactly sure what my style is, but it usually involves walnut. So I'm here at KenCraft, digging through my favorite bin, looking for that perfect piece. This experimental build is brought to us by Squarespace. This Bluetooth speaker cost $90 on Amazon. I chose this one because of the great reviews and how plain it looks. The squareness is going to allow me to customize the crap out of it without disassembling it. The walnut that I got from KenCraft has nice straight grain, which is perfect for resawing and shaping the shell. I'm basically making thin veneers out of this walnut by cutting as thin as possible on the bandsaw and then taking the remaining piece and cleaning that rough cut up on the planer. And then going back to the bandsaw to cut another veneer. I'm going back and forth until I get as many pieces as I need, and then I make them even thinner by running them through the drum sander until I can get them to bend the right amount. I can't explain it, but there are some repetitive tasks in woodworking that I just don't enjoy, like sanding, but making my own veneers is extremely satisfying. I'm gonna use this 3-inch thick dense foam as my mold, which cuts effortlessly on my table saw. The pink, purple, is it pink? Or purple stuff that you get from the home center also would work great for this. So I have three pieces here. I need to glue them together. A quick internet search says I can use spray adhesive. Let's see if this works. The spray adhesive just ate away the foam. So I always thought the internet was always right. Maybe that's just YouTube comments. We're gonna try some hot glue. I think 66 degrees is what I want to use for my angle here. So I'm just going to draw a line. We're winging it today. I don't know if this is going to work. I mean, it's going to work. I'm pretty sure. But there's a chance it might not work. We have our mold. It's gonna go this way and it's got two little feet on the bottom, but it's going to go in the vacuum bag like so. This little cutoff piece right here is going to pinch in there. And so all of these pieces, hopefully, will just get sandwiched in there and bend around. I think I got them thin enough. There's a lot of layers. This is about a half inch thick. So I am using some extended time because I've just got so many to glue up at once. I've never put anything this tall in my vacuum bag. So rule 4 is in full effect. So I had to, it wasn't working. So I had to stand on this guy right here. And I think that is gonna work.
The moment of truth, I'm so nervous.
How long has it been in there? Like an hour and a half?
Hour and a half. I wanted to go 2 hours, but I'm impatient. And it's getting late in the day. So I think it worked. I think it worked really good. These are always so stressful, but when it works, it's so fun. We got the win. We got the W. Dude. I love vacuum press bat laminations. That is so cool.
That's going to sit like that. This is going to go inside here. And there's purposely going to be a space on the bottom. And then we get to cut off the top here. And then we're going to glue in a straight piece of wood and then make room for the buttons up top here. So we got these little buttons right there. So I'm really, really happy. This is why we have to have extra on there to give us room to chop off. We also need to clean up the edges. And so the game plan is this is going to set back a little bit so we can add some grill cloth to the front. And then this will still be inset. So the next thing we gotta do is we're just going to clean this up. We gotta clean up the edges and chop off the top. And that's gonna help us with the game plan. But man, that is so satisfying. We have our pieces cut. This is all shaped and looking good. The top piece is still a little long. We're gonna cut it to length after glue up. I need to make some holes on the top piece to access the buttons. So I made a template that I'm going to attach to this and then use a Forstner bit to drill them out. This is satisfying. This is looking good. You gotta keep your head in the game. You gotta keep your head in the game. So I drilled these holes perfectly center, and that would have meant this would be perfectly center, and it would have not given me enough room for my grill cloth grill area. So I went and remade another piece with them offset, so they're set towards the back a little bit. So now we are going to glue this up. Just gonna add a little bit of glue to the end here. And we should be good. I haven't figured out how to attach this yet. One problem at a time. I got some of this white amplifier grill cloth that we're gonna use for the front. I'm going to draw this shape onto this piece of plywood. And we're gonna cut this out at the bandsaw. I'm liking this so far. The plan was to take this piece of plywood and then glue on some grill cloth on the front. This gets glued inside, and then we were gonna trim this out with more walnut. What I don't like about that now, and I didn't realize that until now, is once we trim that out with walnut, you will see the inside shape of this, unless we do some crazy, like fancy L-shaped trim, which I don't wanna do. I'm scratching all of that. I'm designing on the fly. This is what happens when you design on the fly, but I'm scratching all of that. I'm gonna cut this out of walnut, and then the grill cloth will get glued onto the back of that, and then that can go in there. I think that's the way to go. All right,
So I'm gonna tape this to the bench so I can get it nice and stretched. I'm just gonna hot glue this guy right on there. Trying to line up my grain here. Before we attach that inside there, we're gonna cut these little excess wings off here, round that over, and then work on the buttons. Before I install these buttons, I gotta get a little bit of finish on them. It'll be a little hard to finish later. This is experimental, but I'm gonna take some Gorilla Tape, put it underneath, and then I'm gonna try to drop these buttons onto the tape with a little bit of CA glue as well. That's gonna go on there like that. I'm gonna push, this friction fits in there, butts up against the radio, and then I can flip this over. From the back, I'm gonna use some CA glue and just kinda weld that in place. And we'll just spray a little activator in there to set that right away. While we are putting the finishing touches on this Bluetooth speaker, I'd like to tell you about today's sponsor, and that is Squarespace. I've been using Squarespace for over 10 years for my website, and they've been a supporter of Make Something Here for the last few years. And I've been saying how easy it is to use. It's now even easier thanks to what they call Blueprint. So when you're ready to start a new site, it's going to ask you a series of questions of what kind of site you want, what you want on there. And while you're answering the questions, it's going to build your website for you in the background. You can even populate it with AI that's built into Squarespace if you want to. This is mind-blowing. It has never been easier and quicker to set up a brand new website. I just did a redesign of my site a couple of months ago. It was as easy as swapping out some logos, moving things around, and then changing the color palette. What a time to be alive. It's 2024. Everybody should have a website, even if it's just a single page business card website. We're all makers and woodworkers and crafters and artists. And maybe we meet somebody out in the world that could be a potential client, or we just want to show off our work to somebody. I can just direct them right to my Squarespace site. You can direct them right to your Squarespace site. It has third-party integrations built right into it. I use a company called Printful for all of my print-on-demand stuff. It has never been easier to make a website. Visit squarespace.com, and when you're ready to launch, visit squarespace.com/makesomething for 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. All right, this Bluetooth radio is done. It's a wild and crazy design. That's not gonna sit well with a few people. That's okay. I had some fun with it. I got to experiment with some new techniques. In my woodworking journey, it's really important to think outside the 90 degree square corner box. This is gonna look great in my kitchen. It kind of has that what the heck is that type vibe about it. I'm all good with that. It invokes a conversation, it questions what it is, and triggers an emotion, whether you like it or not. Isn't that what art is?
I'm not exactly sure what my style is, but it usually involves walnut.